Those who are listening to the voice of my voice, today is the last Sunday in the month of March. We thank God for giving us throughout the month of March and throughout these trying times. This is a unique time, and we are running through a strange process. But the Lord Himself has positioned Himself to speak to us, even in a time like this. Shall we pray? Everlasting King of Glory, we thank you. Father, we worship you for a time like this. We thank you for bringing us together to listen to your voice again. You are giving us the assurance that no matter the situation in the world, that you are with us. We should take our rest in you. Therefore, Father, we are resting in your word that you are giving us overwhelming victory over the situation. And we pray that today we speak to us again in accent, receipt, and prayer. Have the way you know. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Today is the next Sunday. It is the last Sunday in the month of March. It is a Sunday that we come together to give thanks to the Lord. All the same, we rejoice that God is good to us. I want to read from Romans chapter 8. We have to be theme for this month from. I read from verse 31. What shall we say about this thing? That is from Romans 8:31. If God is for us, who can ever be against us? I'm reading from the New Living Translation of this. Since he did not spare his own son, but gave it up for us, won't he also give us everything else? Who dares accuse us from whom God has chosen for his own? No one, for God himself has given us right standing with himself. Who then can condemn us? No one, for Christ Jesus died for us and was raised to life for us, and is sitting in the place of honor at God's right hand, pleading for us. Can anything ever separate us from Christ's love? Does it no longer love us if we have trouble or calamity or are persecuted or hungry or destitute or in danger or threatened with death? As the scripture says, for your sake we are killed every day. We are being slaughtered like sheep. No, despite all this, overwhelming victory is ours through Christ who loved us. Paul, in his word, is giving the people assurance that no matter what is happening, God is there. He has sent Christ to the world to die for us. So for any Christian who is discouraged at this time, this powerful passage gives assurance of Christ's present love, active at every moment in our lives. Are any causes of discouragement or are any people discouraged or are thinking that the end is going to come anytime? The end may come, but we should not be afraid. The Lord Himself will speak to us this morning in the name of Jesus. I want us to pray, particularly for this time, that the Lord will give us courage to stand at this time. Let us pray. Let us pray that the Lord will give us courage to stand at this time in the name of Jesus. Father, we pray that at this time, you give us courage to stand in the name of Jesus. As you continue with us, let this service be a unique service of deliverance, of healing, of transformation. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. Hallelujah. Let's just lift our hands wherever we have. Just worship Jesus because we know He's everywhere. He's God. He's everlasting. He's everywhere. He's Jehovah Nissi, Jehovah Shammah. He's Emmanuel, God with us. If you have received us, watching us this morning, we know that Jesus is available, ready to lead us, to touch us. Hallelujah. Lord, we just worship. Thank you, Father. We worship your name as well as your name. Bless your name, God. Yes, you are.
It is well in the name.
Sacrifice
holy and acceptable to God, which are revealed in signs, and be not conformed to this world, but transformed by the renewal of your mind, that you may know the good, the acceptable and the perfect will of God. Our Father is the Holy God, says, be therefore holy, for I, the Lord, the God, is holy. Hallelujah. The requirement for us to go to the holies of holies with our Father, to uphold the throne of grace and boldness, to have access to the supernatural, you must have that holiness which Christ has brought for us with his blood. Our garments must not be stained or wrinkled or soiled by the things of the world. All that may, what we cannot, because we are a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a peculiar people, meant to show for the praise of him who has called out of darkness into his marvelous light. The second goal of the first, sober living. God has not called us to be proud or boastful people, no. He be sober. Say, be that white and serpent, but be gentle, be sober and the dove. Hallelujah. God said, God is not the proud, but he given grace to the humble. A child of God should live soberly in this present world that we have. Don't get carried away by things or the gifts that God has put in your talent that God has put to you. But we will be sober. So our spiritual antenna will work very hard to receive from the things of God. Hallelujah. The talk is law. In the book of Romans, chapter 9 to 10, 12 from 9 to 10, it tells us that law must be without discrimination, must be without greatness, must be without eyesight for the genuine from the heart. In the book of 1 Corinthians, chapter 13, from verse 1, it says, that give my body to be born, and without doing the law, is a waste of time. Hallelujah, the practice of law. It's not proud. It's not self-seeking. It's not vengeful. It beareth all things. So our law must be without it and not be genuine. As Christ Paul was genuine. So while we are sinners, Christ loved us and gave himself for us. Hallelujah. Also, God expects us to live an active Christian life. Hallelujah. The not being slothful in business, but fervent in the spirit, serving the Lord. Procrastination should not be found among believers. Laziness, without laziness, the Bible is quite excess fats, must be trimmed up. The Bible likely they call the child of God to that of the military. Military are known for being disciplined. By following, they are all for their exercise and their training. They don't have to do as extra hours. No, it's time for discipline. It's time for them to all and about. Hallelujah. A Christian life is not a call for laziness, but a call for active service. A call for sacrifice. To go beyond your best. You give your all as Christ gave all for us. Hallelujah. The fifth one is living a life of worship outlook. Hallelujah. That Romans 12:12. I will quickly read that. It says, rejoice in hope, patient in tribulation, continuing instant in prayer. It's not quite about to throw in the tower. No. In the book of Luke, chapter 18, verse 1, he encouraged us. This Christ is the parable to his head that men ought always to pray and not to faint. No time to join the tower. No time to give your life. No time to entertain fear. Hallelujah. We must rejoice in hope. Patience in tribulation, things like come. Not time to lose your head, but time to get yourself together and your prayer bond being fire of us. Hallelujah. We go to the sixth outline, it says living a life of hospitality. Not the hallmark of a Christian. The young church was separated, was distinct with this. They care for everyone, they share everything in common. To the extent that no one lacked anything. We have a scripture that Abraham entertained angels. It should be known as believers that we are hospitable. So many entertained angels by not knowing it. One thing to show, Christ was very hospitable and also links to the act of being compassionate. It's one thing that is lost in the world, but But thank God, one of the positive outcomes of this epidemic is we come to come together. Those that have lost in the materialistic and capitalist world, people come together to help out the aged ones going through challenges who don't have to eat, to reach out to them. This should be the hallmark of Christians. It's the time of our life to shine very well to the world. And we see the love of Christ, even in this difficult hour, in that hour, to shine the light of God through hospitality and compassion to the world. Hallelujah. Also, we have to live the life of faith. Faith is not the absence of challenge or tribulation, but it's you rising up in the middle of the challenges with the shield of faith and flying the banner of Christ. Hallelujah. The book of Hebrews does understand that without faith it's impossible to please God. And he called to God but believe that he exists and the world that needed to seek him. But God that is men of faith, that ordinary men and women, like prayer, like Gideon, like Elisha, how called the man of high passion. But their faith in God distinguished them to become heroes of faith. When the adversity and challenges, it's time for you to carry on the shield of faith and trust in God more. That way you will let the light of God shine through you to touch life. Hallelujah. Also, God expects us to leave us to have forgiveness disposition. Don't say you're a child of God without forgiving. Know what we are praying, right? Someone that just asked Christ, please teach us how to pray. And God says, he said, and forgive our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. A child of God will have this disposition of forgiveness. I asked him how many times the brother sins against you and you forgive. The 70 times 7 in a day. Minimum of 490 times. So we must have a disposition to forgive ahead. Hallelujah. Also, you have the disposition of peace. A child of God will give peace around you. There's no way you can carry the light of the gospel without being peaceable. If you are always quarrelsome or troublesome in your place of work where you live, where you trade, people will not accept the gospel of Christ from you. Every Corinthians should know peace for men and holiness. Without which no man can see God. Even Jesus Christ, one of the statues known as the Prince of Peace. So as the children of the King and the Prince of Peace, we must be an ambassador of peace anywhere we find ourselves. God will help enable us to strengthen us for our battle of peace in Jesus' name. Also, we have to have kingdom orientation. In the book of Romans 4:17, it says the kingdom of God is not in meat or drink, but in power and joy of the Holy Ghost. Let's read there, Romans 14, verse 17. And I read, so for the kingdom of God is not in meat and drink, but righteousness and peace and joy in the Holy Ghost. You must know what matters in the kingdom to be the front runner. Things that are not essential to come on a spiritual seat. Kingdom social, want to know what the will of God is at all point in time. What is the will of God concerning you at all time? When you ask, it's been a moment of going back to see what the mind of God concerning us at this time. Many people in terms of the Israel, they see themselves as grasshoppers. So the land is good, but we are like grasshoppers. But terms of God, they say we are well able to go and take the country. What is God saying to you right now? Are you even on your knees to intervene as Abraham did in the sign? And cry unto God, said, if there are 20 righteous people, we spare the land. Hallelujah. Also, lastly, for a rather, must have acts of gratitude and appreciation as children of God. That is lacking in our life. Many people live day to day without this position of life. When you get to the hospital, many of us will appreciate, you go to you go out and come back as our own privilege. Many of us have not time to go. Like Christ asked the man in here, he said, where are the other nine? Only one came to say thank you. But the Bible says, only that one was made whole. must always appreciate God in our day-to-day life, appreciate one another. Be thankful to greet, give you all new water, food, be thankful to thank you. Hallelujah. Even though I don't provide those things, but I want to teach you to put them together. Took time and effort, must tell us to live a life of opposition to one another, to fellow brethren where we are. And lastly, God has clearly wanted us, God clearly wants the decision to be known to mankind. That's why He gave us the blueprint called the Bible, His Word. The truth is this, don't meet this expectation by human strength. You require the help of the Holy Spirit. But the arm of flesh will fail. But in the Spirit of God, you can do valiantly. I want to start the talk to this morning. Say, Father, grace to meet your expectation. Grace to live a life worthy of you, that will be proud as a father. That you can boast of me as the boast of Job, to say, have you seen my son, Job? Therefore, help me to meet your expectation. Help me to meet with your standard. And for a return to God, met Christ this morning, an opportunity for you to come to Him. The first thing to meet the expectation is to accept Him as the personal Lord and Savior, to give your life to Him. Many grounds are filling people everywhere in their life. The science that I can grapple with this on ground, many experts are confused, governments over the world are trying to grapple with this around them. But it is sure heaven you can count on. But first of all, you must accept Him as your Lord and Savior. He is a shelter in a time of sorrow. If you are in that position, wherever you are, and can hear me, I want you to begin to pray after me. Say, Lord Jesus, I give my life unto you. I confess and acknowledge my sin this morning. I said, Lord, be the Lord of my life. Take utterly control in my life. Holy Spirit, come into my heart this morning. Help me to be a true and faithful child of God. In Jesus' name. Father, as men, I pray this prayer, anywhere they are, on the first of the night. Father, I pray that the Holy Spirit will fill in this heart. Father, appetite for the taste of God, the word of God, to fellowship with brethren come upon them this morning. But I pray that you tell me, but I might give up to ask your hand. Thank you for that, for the answer prayer. For in Jesus' mighty name I pray. Amen.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Thank the Lord for the message that has come forth this morning. We thank the Lord because it is a message of courage. What God expects of us in a time like this, may we not be found wanting in the name of Jesus. Just a few announcements before we close. That the Bible study we hold in our life centers on Thursday between the hours of 6 and 7:30. Thursday in our life centers. Presently we have 12. So the addresses will be on the WhatsApp, on our WhatsApp platform. So you go to the one that is closest to you. And it is our covenant week. We shall also be printing prayer topics on the WhatsApp page. So we should get into it and play in line with what is on the platform. The Lord bless us as we obey in Jesus' name. For our offerings, pledges, vows, tithes, the account number of this church is on the platform too. First Bank Nigeria, account number 2011444295. It is displayed on the screen. I repeat, First Bank of Nigeria, 2011444295. The Lord bless you as you give in Jesus' name. Shall we pray? Our Father and Lord, we thank you for the service of today. We thank you for you have spoken to us. We thank you for your instruments that you have used. Father, we pray for the replenishment of anointing in the mighty name of Jesus. We pray that at this time, visit your church, visit your people, visit our nation, visit the whole world. Bring your bread of life unto us and wipe away this deadly virus. Father, we thank you. Take our praise, Lord. In Jesus' name, we pray.
Amen.